Hello students, welcome back. Students, in previous lecture we discussed osmotic pressure as colligative property. Now students, colligative properties, be it osmotic pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression of freezing point of solvent or relative lowering of vapor pressure, they all can be used to determine molar mass of the solute. And students, these colligative properties, they give accurate molecular mass of solute only under specific conditions. So students, today we are going to discuss what are those conditions which give us accurate molecular mass of solute. So students, we have today's topic, conditions for getting accurate molar mass of solute. So students, molecular mass जो solute का होगा वो accurate कब आएगा? So for that we have conditions. First is that solution should be what? Dilute and ideal. अगर solution dilute और ideal होगा, it will give what? Normal molecular mass or accurate molecular mass. Second condition is that solute should be non-volatile. It should be non-volatile. And third, students, solute should not undergo dissociation or association in the solution. So students, these are the conditions under which we get accurate molecular mass of solute from the colligative properties. Students, so if a solution obeys all these conditions, then the molecular mass of the solute which we observe experimentally will be equal to the normal molecular mass. Normal means the one which is calculated theoretically. So whenever a solution obeys all these conditions, we get what? Normal molecular mass. But students, if any of these conditions is not fulfilled by the solution, then your observed molecular mass will be different from the normal molecular mass. In simple words, students, we say that when any of these conditions is not fulfilled by the solution, we get abnormal molecular mass. So students, next topic is abnormal molecular mass. Students, when the conditions for getting accurate molar mass of solute are not fulfilled by a solution, the observed colligative property value, will be different than the normal colligative property value. Or students, we can say that अगर आपका observed colligative property different है, then your, see this, observed molecular mass or molar mass of the solute will also be what? Different than the normal molecular mass. So it will be different than the normal molecular mass. So in other words, we can say that we get what? We get abnormal. This will be what? Abnormal molecular mass. So students, this is very, very important that substances, they said to have abnormal molecular mass when the solutions are, say, not dilute. Maybe the solute is not non-volatile, or maybe the solute undergoes association or dissociation in the solution. So that means, why do we get this abnormal molecular mass? So students, there are three reasons for that. So we have three reasons for getting abnormal molecular mass. Students, first reason is when the solution is not, say, dilute. Jab solution dilute nahi hai, then we get abnormal molar mass. Why, students? Let us understand that. Students, suppose mere paas ek solute ya solution hai, in which solute particles are A and B. And when we say solution is dilute, these particles, dilute solution mein volume bahut zyada hoga, students. So solute particles, they do not interact. So interactions between them are negligible. But students, when the solution is concentrated, the solute particles are very close and therefore they interact with each other strongly. So students, we can say that in a concentrated solution, the solute particles, they interact with each other strongly. As a result, solution, now the colligative property value of that solution will depend on what? That colligative property value will depend on what? Number of solute particles. Number of solute particles as well as nature of solvent. So this will depend on both now. Sorry, nature of solute. Even students, in concentrated solution, the solute particles jo hai wo aapas mein bhi interact karte hain and they also interact with solvent also. So students, due to these reasons, jo solution hoga, solution becomes what? Solution becomes non-ideal. So under these conditions, solution becomes non-ideal. And jab solution non-ideal ho jayega, students, what? We get abnormal molecular mass. So this is very, very important to note that whenever solution is concentrated, the solute particles, they begin to interact with each other as well as with the solvent, and consequently the solution becomes non-ideal. As a result, we get abnormal molecular mass of solute from the colligative property. Now students, the second reason we have is that when solute undergoes dissociation, when solute undergoes dissociation, अब कोई एक सब्सटेंस है जिसको सॉल्यूशन में डालते ही अगर वो डिसोशिएट हो जाए स्टूडेंट्स तो क्या होगा. सी दिस नाउ, आई हैव NaCl. नाउ NaCl इज एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट विच इन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन डिसोशिएट्स इनटू सोडियम एंड क्लोराइड आयंस. सो दैट मींस इफ वी ऐड वन मोल ऑफ सोडियम क्लोराइड, बट in the solution we will have what? 2 moles of the solute particles. Why? Because sodium and chloride ions, they dissociate. So your what normal colligative property jo hoga, agar dissociation nahi hota students to wo correspond karta kitne moles ko? 1. But students, kyunki solute ka dissociation hua hai, to jo aapka observed colligative property hoga wo kya hoga? Will correspond to, say, जितने ions बने हैं, that means 2. और students, अगर मैं और कोई case लेता हूं, say, I have potassium sulfate, which in aqueous solution dissociates to give potassium ions and sulfate ions. See, this is our potassium sulfate dissociates. Now, suppose अगर मैं इसका 1 mole लेता, तो आपका जो normal colligative property होगा, will correspond to how many moles of solute? 1. But since this substance undergoes dissociation, the resulting solution has how many ions? We have 2 moles of what? Potassium ions and 1 mole of sulfate ion. So resulting solution has how many? 3 moles of the solute particles. So now the colligative property value जो हम ऑब्जर्व करेंगे वो कितने मोल्स के कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग आएगा, 3 के. सो स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट वी ऑब्जर्व इज दैट व्हेन सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स दे अंडरगो डिसोसिएशन, से दिस द कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी वैल्यू ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन व्हाट इंक्रीजेस. व्हाई? बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स इंक्रीज. एज अ रिजल्ट स्टूडेंट्स मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट व्हाट डिक्रीजेस. समझ आया स्टूडेंट्स कि जब डिसोसिएशन होगा नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स इंक्रीज करेंगे. सी दिस, एंड व्हेन नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स इंक्रीज कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी विल इंक्रीज बिकॉज कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी डिपेंड्स ऑन नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स. एंड वी नो दैट कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी एंड मोलर मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूट दे आर इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. सो मोलर मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूट विल डिक्रीज विच मीन्स योर ऑब्जर्व्ड मॉलिक्यूलर मास विल बी लेस देन द नॉर्मल मोलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट. सो व्हेनेवर डिसोसिएशन अकर्स स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट ऑब्जर्व्ड मॉलिक्यूलर मास विल बी लेस देन द नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स द थर्ड रीजन फॉर गेटिंग एबनॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास इज व्हेन सॉल्यूट अंडरगोज एसोसिएशन. So when solute undergoes association, what happens? See, first let me give you one example, students. Carboxylic acids in benzene undergo dimerization. That means the two molecules of acetic acid, they dimerize, that is they associate to form a dimer. That means a single molecule. So students, here what happens is that jitne bhi aapne solute particles se originally liye the, they all dimerize, that means they all polymerize, and we get what? Half the molecule, solute particles in the solution. Means aapke paas solution mein, see, pehle do the, theek hai, association nahi hua hai, abhi zero hai, but jab association ho gaya to ye aapke paas से, अगर मैं मान रहा हूं एसोसिएशन 100% हो गया ये नहीं बचेगा, बट अब सॉल्यूट में सॉल्यूशन में कितने पार्टिकल्स होंगे, अगर ये दो थे सॉल्यूशन में एक रह जाएगा बिकॉज ऑफ डाइमराइजेशन. स्टूडेंट इसी तरह से अगर ट्राइमराइजेशन हो जाता, अब ये एक बात देख लो दैट जितने पार्टिकल्स आपके पास थे डाइमराइजेशन पे सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स कितने हो गए, हाफ. सो स्टूडेंट्स अगर ट्राइमराइजेशन होता यानी ट्राइमर बनता तो आपके पार्टिकल्स कितने हो जाते, 1/3, और अगर टेट्रामर बनता तो आपके पास 1/4 हो जाते. सो दैट मींस व्हेनेवर एसोसिएशन टेक्स प्लेस नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स जितने भी आपने लिए थे नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स क्या हो जाएंगे, उससे कम हो जाएंगे. ये डिपेंड करता है अब एसोसिएशन कितने मॉलिक्यूल्स का हो रहा है. सो स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम दिस एग्जाम्पल वी कंक्लूड दैट upon what association, whenever association occurs, see what happens, number of solute particles in the solution decrease, consequently the colligative property value will also decrease because colligative property is directly proportional to the number of solute particles. And students, since colligative property and molar mass, they are inversely proportional, we say the molar mass of solute will increase, which means students, the observed molecular mass of the solute will be greater than the normal molar mass of solute. Or we simply say, we get abnormal molar mass. Example de deta hun students. The normal molar mass of acetic acid, ye hai formula, when we calculate we get 60 gram per mole. But students, in benzene, acetic acid dimerizes. So benzene mein jo uska solution aap banaoge, usme aapko discrete acetic acid molecules nahi milne wale, rather you get a dimer. Aur agar main maan lu dimerization 100% hua hai, then your observed molecular mass will be what? Twice of 60, that is 120 gram per mole. So that means whenever association takes place, your observed molecular mass, depending upon the degree of association, will always be what? Greater than the normal molar mass. Or simply we say, we get what? Abnormal molar mass. So students, this was the concept of abnormal molar mass of solute. Now students, अब अगर किसी सॉल्यूशन में सॉल्यूट का एसोसिएशन या डिसोसिएशन हुआ है तो उसका एक्सटेंट हमें पता होना चाहिए सो दैट वी कैन अप्लाई अ करेक्शन फैक्टर टू गेट एक्यूरेट मॉलिक्यूलर मास फ्रॉम अ कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी. बिकॉज स्टूडेंट्स, किसी सब्सटेंस के नेचर में अगर डिसोसिएट करना है लिखा है तो वो डिसोसिएट करेगा, और कोई सब्सटेंस अगर एसोसिएट करता है तो वो करेगा, वो हम नहीं रोक सकते. बट एक चीज हम कर सकते हैं, वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस और वी कैन अप्लाई सम करेक्शन फैक्टर सो दैट वी गेट नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन ऑर्डर टू गेट एक्यूरेट और नॉर्मल मोलर मास फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सॉल्यूशंस वेयर सॉल्यूट अंडरगोज डिसोसिएशन और मे बी द सॉल्यूट अंडरगोज व्हाट एसोसिएशन, अ करेक्शन फैक्टर वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अ साइंटिस्ट वॉन्ट हॉफ. And this factor therefore is called Wonthoff factor. And it is denoted by Greek letter iota. So students, what is Wonthoff factor? Wonthoff factor is a correction factor which is used to express the extent of ionization or we say extent of dissociation or association of the solute particles. And it is defined as, students, iska definition, the answer, it is defined as the ratio of what? Normal molar mass of, say, solute to observed molar mass of solute. So this is how we define it. Now here I'm defining it in terms of what? Molar mass. Or we can also define iota, that is Wonthoff factor, in terms of colligative property. Students, molar mass and colligative properties are inversely proportional. So that means in terms of colligative property, we say iota is defined as ratio of observed colligative property to what? Normal colligative property. Aisa maine isliye likha students, because we know that colligative property and molar mass are inversely proportional. So students, now let's discuss the value of Wonthoff factor in case of dissociation and association. Now students, see this. We have just learned that in case of dissociation, jab bhi dissociation hota hai, the number of solute particles increase in the solution, colligative property value jo observed hoga wo bhi badh jayega aur usse molar mass kam aayega. That means your observed molar mass is what? Less than the normal molar mass. And students, iota we know is what? Iota is normal molar mass to observed molar mass. Ab students, normal molar mass to jyada hai, means numerator denominator se bada hai. So students, jab aisa hoga, so in case of dissociation, since आपका नॉर्मल मोलर मास ऑब्जर्व्ड मोलर मास से ज्यादा होगा तो आपका ये जो आयोटा का वैल्यू होगा इट विल बी ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन वन. स्टूडेंट्स, अभी तक हमने ये करेक्शन फैक्टर क्यों यूज नहीं किया वो याद रखो, दैट क्योंकि अभी तक हमने जो भी कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी स्टडी की है वी अज्यूम्ड दैट सॉल्यूट डज नॉट डिसोशिएट और एसोशिएट, सो वी वर टेकिंग एक्चुअली नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स, और सभी नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स के लिए ऑब्जर्व्ड और नॉर्मल मोलर मास सेम होता है तो Wonthoff फैक्टर वन होता है. सो दैट मींस आप उसको कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी के रिजल्ट में लिखो ना लिखो फर्क नहीं पड़ता. बट व्हेन डिसोसिएशन अकर्स वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट आयोटा फर्स्ट एंड देन वी अप्लाई दिस सो एज टू गेट एक्यूरेट रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी. एंड रिमेंबर दिस, व्हेनेवर डिसोसिएशन अकर्स आयोटा विल ऑलवेज बी ग्रेटर देन वन, हमेशा आयोटा एक से ज्यादा ही होगा जब डिसोसिएशन होगा. Now students, secondly, when association takes place, say this, इन केस ऑफ एसोसिएशन, नाउ क्या होता है एसोसिएशन में, एसोसिएशन होने से जो आपके नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स हैं रिजल्टिंग सॉल्यूशन में वो नॉर्मली जितने होने से चाहिए थे उससे कम होंगे. सो कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी वैल्यू भी देयरफॉर कम होगा. बट कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी वैल्यू कम होने का मतलब है ऑब्जर्व्ड मॉलिक्यूलर मास ज्यादा आएगा. सो इन केस ऑफ एसोसिएशन ऑब्जर्व्ड मॉलिक्यूलर मास इज ग्रेटर देन द नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास और नॉर्मल मोलर मास. एंड स्टूडेंट्स देयरफॉर आयोटा विच इज व्हाट रेशियो ऑफ नॉर्मल टू ऑब्जर्व्ड. बट अब आपका क्या है, सी आपका ये जो नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास है दैट इज न्यूमरेटर में जो टर्म है वो छोटा है और डिनोमिनेटर बड़ा है. सो स्टूडेंट्स इससे क्या होगा, योर आयोटा विल बी लेस देन वन. सो स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नोट दैट इन केस ऑफ डिसोसिएशन आयोटा एक से ज्यादा होगा एंड इन केस ऑफ एसोसिएशन आयोटा विल बी लेस देन वन. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स बाय यूजिंग दिस करेक्शन फैक्टर दैट इज वन हाफ फैक्टर वी कैन मॉडिफाई द कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी रिजल्ट्स. How? See, first colligative property which we discussed was relative lowering in vapor pressure, and we know that relative lowering in vapor pressure is given by this equation. It is equal to mole fraction of solute. But students, ye result applicable tha for non-electrolytes, means substances which do not dissociate or associate. But when dissociation or association occurs, in order to find accurate results, we apply what correction factor iota. Or what is xp? It is number of moles of solute divided by number of moles of solute and solvent. So ye aa jayega. But students jab aap isko apply karoge, remember this, that relative lowering in vapor pressure in case of electrolyte. Ab dissociate kaun kar raha hai? Dissociate karta hai sirf solute. So, ये तो वॉन ऑफ फैक्टर है स्टूडेंट्स. हम आयोटा सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स के मोल्स के साथ लगाएंगे. सो आयोटा इंटू एनपी इसके साथ नहीं लगाएंगे बिकॉज सॉल्वेंट डज नॉट डिसोशिएट. सो हम आयोटा जो फैक्टर है उसको अटैच करेंगे या अप्लाई करेंगे विद मोल्स ऑफ सॉल्यूट ओनली. सो स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, अदरवाइज आपका रिजल्ट सही नहीं आएगा. सेकेंड कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी रिजल्ट कैन बी मॉडिफाइड. Now, second colligative property was elevation of boiling point. And now, for electrolytes, the result is modified by applying correction factor iota, which is iota into Kb into molality of solution. So, this is elevation in boiling point for electrolytes. Third, we studied depression of freezing point of solvent, which will also be iota into Kf into molality. And thirdly, students, we studied osmotic pressure pi, which actually is given by CRT, but in case of electrolytes, we use iota CRT. So, students, अब आपको मैं बता दूँ ये जो iota है वैसे आप इसको अब आदत में डाल लो, because अब हुआ क्या है ये chapter के end में आया term, but जब आप competitive exams के लिए study करते हो, अब मान के चलो ये iota हमेशा ही है. अब substance को आप देख लो, अगर तो वो इलेक्ट्रोलाइट है आपको आयोटा निकालना पड़ेगा, और अगर वो नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट है तो वो डिसोशिएट और एसोशिएट नहीं करेगा. मींस नॉर्मल और ऑब्जर्व्ड मॉलिक्यूलर मास इक्वल होंगे, आयोटा विल बी वन. तो उस केस में आप वन लिखोगे तो इक्वेशन वही रहेगा. सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नोट दैट आयोटा के बिना आपने कोई भी कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी रिजल्ट नहीं निकालना है, अदरवाइज आपका रिजल्ट इनएक्यूरेट आएगा. बट अगर आप इसको अप्लाई करते हो you get accurate results from colligative properties. So students, now we will discuss relationship between want of factor and extent of association or dissociation. Students, now we'll relate want of factor iota and extent of dissociation, say alpha. Now students, say I have an electrolyte, say A, X, B, Y. So this is an electrolyte which in say aqueous solution undergoes dissociation to give X moles of A carrying Y positive charge and Y moles of B carrying X negative charge. Now, students, initially say I have 1 mole of this electrolytic substance. So this means, students, the normal colligative property value of this solution should correspond to how many moles of solute? One. Ye tab hai, students, jab main assume karun that the solute does not dissociate. But students, AXBY to electrolyte hai, wo dissociate karega. And say, if alpha is degree of dissociation, if alpha is degree of dissociation, agar is substance ka degree of dissociation in the solution is alpha, that means out of 1 mole, alpha moles dissociate. So how many moles of the solute will remain in the solution undissociated? Solution mein rahenge kitne? This will be 1 minus alpha. So students, iske kitne moles banenge? Ab iska 1 mole hai, to iske x moles hai. So this will be x alpha. Iske kitne moles hai y? So this will be y alpha. So solution mein hamare paas total moles kitne aage? Ek to ye plus ye bhi honge. So that means the total number of moles in the solution of solute particles after dissociation, we have how many? 1 minus alpha plus we have what? These many also. That is x plus y alpha. Now students, in general suppose x or y ka sum karke n aata hai. Means, ab ye 4 hai, ye 2 hai, to 6 bhi ho sakte hai. Agar ye 1 hai aur 1 hai, to 2 hai. So if x plus y is equal to n, we write the total number of moles, means observed number of moles of solute particles in the solution. We have 1 minus alpha and let x plus y ka jo sum karke aata, it is n alpha. So students, after this, aapke paas observed number of moles ab ye hai. So agar aapka normal colligative property 1 mole ke corresponding aana chahiye tha, so now students, observed colligative property will be corresponding to how many moles of the solute? Wo hoga students, 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. So this is your observed colligative property. Now students, agar aapko normal colligative property pata hai, aapko observed colligative property pata hai, we can determine what? Von't Hoff factor, that is iota. So students, iota will be what? Observed colligative property to normal colligative property. And what is observed colligative property? It is 1 minus alpha plus n alpha, and your normal colligative property is 1. So students, from this we get iota, that is Von Hoff factor, is 1 plus alpha n minus 1. So this is how we determine what iota in terms of degree of dissociation. And students, from this we can find out alpha, which will be what? Iota minus 1 upon n minus 1. So students, this is how we express Von Hoff factor in terms of degree of dissociation. Now let's discuss with the help of one example. Say I have NaCl, students. So NaCl dissociates to give. So here number of solute particles we have how many? 2. So alpha will be what? Yeah, iota kar lete hain. Iota will be what, students? It will be 1 plus alpha 2 minus 1. So iota will be 1 plus alpha. So ye ho gaya relation. And assuming that alpha jo iska hai, kyunki NaCl is a strong electrolyte, alpha is 100%, that means 1. So alpha will be, say iota will be 1 plus 1, students, ye aa jayega aapka 2. So that means when dissociation is 100%, ye result aapka ek generalization ho gaya. Iota ka value hamesha yaad rakhna, whenever alpha is 100%, that is 1, your iota will always be equal to number of ions in the solution. Jaise yahan 2 tha to yahan 2 aayega. Agar kisi electrolyte mein 3 ions honge, to assuming that alpha is 1, ye थ्री आएगा, बट इन एन अदर इन ऑल अदर केसेस जब अल्फा का वैल्यू 100 से कम होगा वी गेट अ डिफरेंट वैल्यू, बट वो जो भी वैल्यू होगा वो होगा एक से ज्यादा ही, क्योंकि डिसोसिएशन में वांड ऑफ फैक्टर इज ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन वन. सो स्टूडेंट्स दैट इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस वांड ऑफ फैक्टर एंड डिग्री ऑफ एसोसिएशन. थैंक यू.